Have you ever had a traumatic surgery, a broken bone, or even a sore back? Chances are you've taken opioids. But what are these? Well, let's start from the beginning. Traditionally, opioids are produced from two flowers, Papaver somniferum and Papaver setigerum. The petals and seeds of these poppies contain alkaloids such as morphine and codeine, which can then be harvested, extracted, and sold commercially for uses such as pain management. Thebaine, an intermediate found in the poppies, can be processed chemically to produce other drugs such as the semi-synthetic compound hydrocodone. Simple, right? Well, not exactly. You see, these opium poppies are less than ideal to cultivate. They require lots of land, nutrient-rich soil, good irrigation, daily care, and are very dependent on seasonal changes, meaning harvest is only once a year. These factors make opium production expensive and inefficient for a relatively low final yield. Due to this, every year, more than 83% of the world's population misses out on proper pain management. So, how do we improve opioid production? One solution was to increase yields in opium poppies via artificial engineering, which has been a success, however, does not rectify the issues associated with environmental factors, incomplete genome mapping, and expensive laboratory tools. Then came a brilliant idea. What if opioids were not made via plant-based manufacturing? What if we used bread? That's right, let's try out microbial-based manufacturing. But we won't use bread, we'll use its main ingredient, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, or baker's yeast. In theory, it is a suitable model to improve some aspects of opioid production, as cultivation time is over days and it can be grown and processed in a lab, meaning little space is required and no environmental factors will affect production. Yeast is a simple organism and already has a complete genetic map, meaning it is already well understood. Current successes of transgenesis in yeast for production of pharmaceutical treatments such as human insulin, hepatitis vaccines, and human papillomavirus vaccines further suggest viability of opioid production. With growth factors improved upon, we now need to consider the feasibility of this task and how great the final yield will be. So, how do we go about doing this? Meet Stephanie Galanie and her team of researchers. Genetic engineering and transgenesis in various strains of yeast has been the focus of their research for many years. So, let's lay out the key points. Opium poppies are naturally able to produce alkaloids, but this isn't the case for yeast. So, strains of yeast were engineered for expression of heterologous enzyme and protein genes from the opium poppy,
the bacterium Pseudomonas putida,
and mammalian samples. Some components of the yeast were either kept or optimized in the process. These enzymes were localized in their respective compartments, including the mitochondria, vacuoles, and endoplasmic reticulum of the yeast, in order to replicate similar processes in the opium poppies. This created optimal environments for the opioid pathway to occur. Not only were alkaloids and semi-synthetic compounds successfully produced, but a new pathway was uncovered that produced compounds such as neopine and neomorphine, but the functions of these are still currently unknown. Replicating the complexity of heterologous gene expression from other organisms into yeast leaves a lot of room for error. Low titer and issues in complete compound conversion were found to be the obvious issues. Later research by Galanie was key to the improvement of this. Downstream products were increased via the modification and overexpression of enzymes in early biosynthetic steps. Incorrect compound conversions were resolved via introduction of new enzymes. For example, conversion of S reticulin to R reticulin was upregulated by integration and overexpression of DRS-DRR from Papaver bracteatum. These improvements in expression and placement of enzymes were successful for the increase of opioid yield. This research by Galanie greatly promotes the feasibility of opioid production from yeast, and her further research proves that key steps can be improved upon. There does, however, remain great concern and some limitations with the process. Despite the improvement of titer within Galanie's research via modifications made, yield of the opioids is not large enough to justify switching from poppy to yeast. Furthermore, due to the addictive nature of opioids, it is worried that the promise of quick, large-scale production and sale will cause an increase in illicit drug use. Homebrew drugs are also a major worry, as yeast is far more accessible to the general public than opium poppies. These situations are currently unlikely to occur, as the process requires such large amounts of yeast and expensive laboratory equipment. However, if refinement of the production process continues, a global problem could ensue. More research and more measures must be put into place before commercialization can occur. So, can the yeast that we use to make bread and vaccines fix your back pain? Yes. The synthesis of opioids such as morphine and codeine from Saccharomyces cerevisiae is very feasible. It presents a more hopeful future for the pharmaceutical industry and is a positive outlook for the people worldwide that are currently missing out on access to this treatment. However, we still have a long way to go before it can be upscaled to a commercial level. Until then, more research!